Anne and welcome back to my channel. It's Anne Daily Life Vlog. So today I would like to interview someone who's I just met. So I would like to call Tatay to come here and to share his life story. So Tatay. Okay. Ega ora tay. So tatay, mangutaw na ako. Unsay imong ngalan?
Romy Arafa.
So, I asked him earlier what his name. His name is Aruni Arafa. Asa ka kanang tinanggad nga
puyo? Mambuyog, Bugay, Bayawan, Negros Oriental.
So, and he's living in
Mambuyog,
Bugay, Bayawan, Negros Oriental. That's the place where I'm going to show you next. But tatay, before so di pa ko magsugod tay ha. Kumusta na ko tay? Unsa kinabuhi niyo tay before nga wala pa ang inyong pinabuhi ang kinabuhan before? So wala pa jud. Unsa man jud? Kanang
tubo, dayon mais, humay. Yung ginagmay ra kayo among makita dayon karon mauning nahitabo nga ning ulan sayo pa wala makuha among produkto o naaga ni na makita nimo ang tubo nga naaras daplin nagutang.
So what tatay said that their life source of income is sugar cane, rice field, corn field also, and a little bit of sand foods like that. But they have a problem right now because usually the rain will be coming on, I think, November. But this year, it is really early for them to get the rain season. So that a lot of their products right now can't get into the production. And it's not really easy. So, tay, giun sa ninyo pag-survive tay nga sa tuod na wala pagkikuha ang inyong produkto tay. Giun sa ninyo nga pag nang survive tay, nang di, kung ano ninyo, di kaya ninyo.
Na makiyaw ko ugwan, bunglay, panipsip ana sa tao para na makapalit ko ugugas. Makapalit mi sa sulod sa panimalay, makakwartar ko, kay mag-inadlaw ko.
So, right now, I asked tatay about how did you survive when the products didn't come to the production. So, tatay said to me that he's working a little bit of in the rice field, someone's rice field, to maintain their medicine and to buy some rice. Because right now, especially here in Negros Oriental, it is MECQ, which is lockdown again. So a lot of the production or the company is locked down or temporary closed. So, tay, pila naman kumuha ka tuig niya, gatubo tayo ng may lumakan.
Halin sa pag-minyo na ko, mga 40 years na karon.
Wow! So this start, I asked tati again about how many years they started to have a sugarcane and rice field. This started when they are getting, when he get married around 40 years. That's a very long time. And kabalo ko tayo nga, dili sa yun ang pag-maintain anang tubo o kanang pag palain nyo tay o kanang sa rice field nyo tay giun sa ninyo na tay pagsugod dun
sa wala pa ko yung mga anak.
Oo.
Pagsugod na ko nangayo na ko mga similya sa ako mga silingan para makasugod ginagmay isa dayon hantog nga makaabot o usa ka truck ng ako nga gitanong.
Wow. So I asked that how did he started about the sugarcane and the rice field. Like what he said that he asked someone to get some seeds or I don't know what's really called, the little sugarcane guys. And then until then he can get one truck of sugarcane, that's the time that he will get more. So tay, pila ka buhok anak mo tay?
Mga unom ni sila.
Wow. Half of a dozen.
Tulo ba eh? Tulo laki.
So, he have 6 children, 3 boys and 3 girls. Tay, kanang sa unang nimo tay, wala anong kay problema tay no? Wala.
Wala.
Mga puro mga buotan.
Buotan man sila dahil na nagtrabaho ra sila og mga
nagkamot
sila.
Ay, kasakit na tay no. Like I admire a lot of the Filipinos who are so tay, kumutan na ako nimo tay. Kanang sa lockdown pinakauna tay nga di ba bawal man magawas? So giunsa ninyo pag survive tay sa kay inyong mga anak tay na lockdown po tay. Giunsa ninyo?
Ako dili gani ko kagawas sa balay kay 63 na ko. Ang among nahimo sa ako asawa na nanumi mga utanon sa kilid sa balay na ako kay duha ka punuan nga suwa nang manguha ko dahil ako ipinda mamirkuli sa bugay mo among ipalit sa among sulod panimalay mga asin
mga
bulad ana para na mahimo nga makaon kay duha na lamang mi nabilin diri sa balay wala na may masugo
kunoon magtigay imong mga anak rin kay kanman. So right so now guys I just asked tatay about how did he survive or his wife also survived during the lockdown. So tatay said that they are planting a lot of vegetables and if he had a fruit of 2 or 3 fruit that he will go to the town to sell them and then after that one they will buy some rice and some fish like dried fish. That's because usually a Filipino that's the thing that they can afford. Right now, when you are buying some meat or fish, it's really expensive during that time. So, tay, giunsa ninyong pag-kontak-kontak sa mong anak during anong time atay nga? Para di po kang mabalaka, tay.
Okay, gipalitan ba nila o cellphone na itong gamay para nga makakontak sila. Marang magpangamusta sila kung saan mo pag survive ning amo nga kwan amo gisugin lang amo sila nga mauna among gihimo na nanumi og mga utanon nagiya ko og mga kalamunding sa kwan bugay para manami mo palit.
So I asked tatay about how and his tatay about how did he contact with their children. Well the kids provide a keypad phone for them to contact them to ask them if they're alright. So, tay, naka-stay naman yung kudal tayo, no? Naka-puyot naman kung pinaka-andal tayo. Wala may kurindi na tayo, no?
Wala.
Oh, so guys, here's the problem, guys. During, when I stayed here, it's really, for them needs to, need an electricity and, water line. Because it's too far when they're going to the river or to the well that they're going to have, get water from their house, for their house. And especially at night time, guys, seriously, I'm not joking, guys, it's really dark. It's not that I'm complaining, it's just that I want to help them through my this information that I would like to share you guys, because here in mountain it's too far from the town, so they're using some a little bit of battery that will help them to have a light, but it's not enough, guys. So tay, kana tay is pila mo ko to ignore ko rin tay. So good
yan sa pag kuana mo.
Papuyo ni dre.
Oo, pagpuyo na mo dre.
Hala.
Wala gid mi kurinti.
Hala. See guys, they have no light started when they're living here in this mountain. It's really hard to live. I can't imagine living here, guys. I can't, because you know me, I can't survive without lights. And, tay, saludo ko tay, giunsa ni mo pagbadako imong mga anak. And, ang gihapon ka tay ng positive gihapon ka tay. Wala akong katuong, may abang pamilya tay, nga di, surrender na lang tay, kay sobra ng kapoy na kayo, sa ilang kapabrihon. Pero, ikaw tay, saludo kayo ni mo tay. Guys, you never saw a Filipino guy who will work hard for this family. Because a lot of them just staying at home, chilling, drinking. But tatay, worked hard really to support his family during when his daughter and child sons still young. But now, Tay, it's really I appreciate ko ni mo, Tay, kay ni share ka sa mo hang story, Tay. Then na kuan po ni mo ang mga tao, Tay, nga ingin ana ang sitwasyon. So I can't say any word, guys. It's like shock, and I won't really help them, but hopefully, guys, in one day that I could help them. So anyway, guys, thank you again, Tatay. Salamat kayo, Tay. So anyone, so guys, please do subscribe on my channel and please hit the notification bell and also the like button, and don't forget to always have positive mind. See you around, guys. Bye-bye.